Everywhere at the Palace of Whitehall, in the Queen's closet by Bishop Gardiner on the 30th of May, just 11 days after Anne's execution. Henry's wedding gift to me being 104 manors in 4 counties, with hunting rights and forests to provide me with my income as Queen. My motto as Queen, bound to obey and serve, was a shrewd move on my part, don't you think? Proclaimed Queen Consort in June, yet my coronation had to be delayed as the plague was rife in London. But no matter, I am far from ambitious as my predecessor was to timidity. My loyalty toward the late Queen Catherine and my obvious compassion and empathy for her poor daughter, the Lady Mary, endeared me to the public. Mayhap you have already judged me. Mayhap Jane Seymour, the timid little mouse, has not the roar of a lion. Mayhap you think you know Jane Seymour. Methinks you will most certainly be wrong. I ran my household with formality and suffered no fool gladly. My ladies were expected to strictly adhere to my rules and to demonstrate their piety and devotion. I immediately rid my court of that racy French fashion so loved by Queen Anne. No, at my court there would be no lavish and no salacious entertainment, no extravagance, and woe betide any of my ladies who did not conduct themselves with decorum at all times. I would not stand by and witness my husband's eye landing on one of my ladies. My husband would have an eye for only me. My regime was at least popular with my kin, my sister-in-law, and the Lady Lyle. And my relationship with my dear stepdaughter, the Lady Mary, flourished, soon becoming firm friends. I worked carefully, and at a length to get Henry to see the good and joy in his first-born daughter. I tentatively tried to have her restored to the line of succession, and, whilst not successful, it was of great satisfaction and comfort that Henry had welcomed her back into the bosom of the family, and that they were reconciled. Previously, I had dared dip my toe into the affairs of men. Politics. In 1536, I sought pardons for those sentenced to death for their involvement in the Pilgrimage of Grace, but shied away when reminded by my husband of the fate of my predecessor and how she had paid for meddling in his affairs. I did not need telling twice. The following year, however, Henry would forgive me for anything. I was with child, a prince for sure. I had a fancy for quail eggs, and so Henry had these brought to me from Calais in Flanders. I took no public engagements and was attended by the best physicians and midwives in the land. I felt magnificent. I would deliver what Henry and the country so desired. I would be the most loved and revered queen who ever reigned. Or would I? Join me next time to find out.